In front of me lining up right now is the Elyria High School Madrigals. Thanks to them, they will be singing when I get my color guard on the stage, which is also Elyria High's ROTC. Once they're all together and on the stage, he will start out with the Star Spangled Banner, preceded by the pledge, which will be led by our current queen. She was crowned yesterday about 3 o'clock.
We don't want to crush that.
Queen Becca Reese. With that, if we could have the color guard, come on, please. Turned in for judging. Even at that, those that came in to be judged, we had about 1,000. Unbelievable. Thank you to the art teachers and the art of school systems for allowing us to have that happen. Today we're going to be honoring those that were named best costume, best message, best color, and most creative. They will be first, second, and third in age third, fourth, and fifth. Our next category is 6th, 7th, and 8th. Our last one is 9 through 12. Assisting me today to do that will be Mel Rainey, the art teacher in charge.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I want to give a special thanks to our classroom teachers that allowed our elementary students. They have kind of a crazy schedule, so I just wanted to give a shout out to all of our elementary classroom teachers who allowed that free time in their classroom to allow the students to do their work under the guidance of our teachers. So today we have our teachers from our elementary grade. We have Heather Hale. Come on up. John Filippiak. Nicole Danji. From our junior highs, we have Elizabeth Carbon, Ann Kalenda, Ryan Eagle, and from high school, assisting me at high school, we have Mike Fran. And this is Gina Lowry. Come on up. The award ceremony presentation of the Young Trigger Creative Artworks. We're going to start with grades 3, 4, and 5, and I'm going to work through the categories most creative, best use of color, and best message. So with our most creative, first place, Abigail Prantler from Prospect. You guys are going to come up, meet your art teacher. We're going to shake hands, move right down the line here with Linda Brown and Ronald McDonald. Jessamay Sherman from Ely. Arabella Sauer from Custwick. Best use of color, first place Geraldine Jackson from Custwick. Second place, Vanessa Brown-White from McKinley. Third place, Sierra Goulet from McKinley.
Now.
Best message category, first place, Morgan Bills from Oakwood. Second place, Quentin King from Oakwood. And third place, Ayanna Barbie from Oakwood. Now for our 6th, 7th, and 8th graders, most creative, first place, Zachary Jockel. Second place, Shauna Andrews from Westwood. Third place, Madison Longo from Westwood. Best use of color, first place, Leanna Medina from Northwood. Second place is Emma Bakos from Northwood. Third place, Lizzie Summers from Northwood. Best message category, first place, Amy Smith from Westwood. Second place, Timothy Roberts from Westwood. And third place, Mackenzie Taylor from Westwood. Now on to the high school's 9th through 12th grade winners. Most creative first place, Grace Johnson. Second place, Sierra Carpenter. Costle. category, first place Sarah Schneider. Second place, Alexander Lucas.
Good afternoon, everyone, and a happy Sunday here
the city of Elyria on this beautiful day. Let's hear it for all of our winners and the staff. This competition is an awesome opportunity for our kids and our staff members to excel and show this community what the Elyria schools are all about. And that's what I'm going to talk about just for a couple minutes here are the Elyria schools. I tell you, as you sit here on stage today, we have nothing but talented young people who love this community and love to do great things for this community, along with staff members, teachers, who work hard each and every day to make sure the controls and the curriculum and all the assignments and everything that they do are complete to the best of their ability. And that's what makes the Elyria School so special. We have a staff that truly cares about the kids, they build relationships, they care about the kids, and they expect nothing but the best from them. And guess what they do when they expect that? They give the best. So let's give our teachers a big round of applause. Many things with this job, and a lot of it has to do with talking, but the best thing that I enjoy doing is talking about our kids and our staff, because we are second to none here in the Elyria City Schools. We're sitting there with all brand new buildings being built from pre-K to grade 8. You're going to see a new multi-sports complex being erected here in the next month and a half or 2 months. You're going to see two schools being built, one on the current Hamilton School site, will be torn down, and you'll see a new school grown up on Pioneer Field, by the soccer field, as well as a new school grown up on the Ely School grounds. So again, you're gonna see a lot of demolition taking place, you're gonna see a lot of growing taking place, and it's all because you support our school system. You supported the bond issue, which gave us the opportunity to bring close to $140 million worth of construction jobs to this community. So we are absolutely on a roll. We're celebrating our 200th anniversary as a city. We're celebrating 200 years as a school system. And we're celebrating it because of these young people over here to my right. So let's give them one more round of applause. Let's see the pioneers here. Give them a thumbs up. Give them a thumbs up. You know what to do. Pioneer Spirit is alive here in Elyria. Thank you. Have a blessed day. God bless each and every one of you. Thank you.